Welcome to my video. In this video, I'm going to teach you what is classification, which is module 4 of VTU syllabus in data mining and warehousing. Yes, already we have seen what are the tasks that can be performed in the data mining. The first one is clustering, then association rules, then classification. These are all the tasks that can be done in the data warehousing, we said in the module 2. Now I'm going to teach you what is classification, and this is the module 4. So as the name suggests, given a collection of records, each record is characterized by a tuple. Each record is characterized by a tuple x comma y, where x is the attribute set and y is the class label. Yes, so what can you understand? You leave these things. What can you understand if I say the word classification? The classification is nothing but classifying some items. So if I have a set of vegetables, so how can I classify green leafy vegetables and the usual vegetables? Then if I have fruits, how can I classify it as a red colored fruits and the other colored fruits? If I have animals, how can I classify wild animals and the domestic animals? So what I'm doing with the items whichever I have, if I'm doing any division or any classification and I'm moving the items to a particular division or classification, then the operation is called classification operation. The same thing we are going to do here. Why we have to classify in data warehouse is, see, in the data warehouse we'll be having lot of data. So we have to classify the data so that the retrieval will be very easy. So if I classify all the green leafy vegetables in one basket and all the other vegetables in one basket, so if at all the customer is asking for green leafy vegetables, then I'll be going to only that basket and I can take. If it is mixed with all the vegetables, if the green leafy vegetables are mixed with the other vegetables, then we have to search. So obviously the retrieval time will be high. That is why we have to classify the things and place it properly so that the data retrieval will also be easy or it will be efficient. So that is the ultimate aim of classification. Yes, now we will see the definition. Each record is characterized by a tuple. So in the data warehouse, every record has a tuple, has a row, which contains x and y, where x is the attribute set and y is the class label. So the attribute set is nothing but the value of that column. What is the column name? It is nothing but class label. So y is class label and x is the value of that class label. So x is nothing but can be attribute or predictor or independent variable or input, and y is, it can be any class or response or dependent variable or output. Then task. So what is the task that can be done? This learn a model that maps each attribute set x into one of the predefined class label y. So what we have to do with the classification or the classifier is, if they give a item, then we should be able to classify the item. See, if I have been given with the spinach, then I should be able to classify it as green leafy vegetable. So that is the use of our classifier. Okay, so how can we do it? Is it possible to do manually? No. So what we are going to do, we are going to create a model which will classify by taking the input that this is the green leafy vegetable and it's a normal vegetable. How that model will classify the classify every item as a green leafy or normal vegetable is, first it has to study, it has to learn from that data set, and from that it will come to know that if spinach is there, it is green leafy vegetable. If radish is there, it's not green leafy vegetable. If tomato is there, it's not green leafy vegetable. If coriander is there, it is green leafy vegetable. So first it will take the test data and learn from the it will take the data and it will learn from that and the model will be having model will be creating the conditions, like if it is green and if it has the following properties, it will be classified as the green leafy vegetables. This is what it will study, and it will find some conditions. If it is green in color, then classify it as green leafy vegetable. If it is not green, then move to the non green leafy vegetable. Like that, it will study based on the properties or the conditions, then it will classify. If all the properties are satisfied, then it will be classified as green leafy. If the property is not satisfied, then it will be classified as a non green leafy vegetables. So this is how our classifier will learn the data set. Then it will come out with the properties, and with after learning, the model will be ready to classify the items whichever is has been given. So this is what the use of the classifier. Then examples of classification task, we'll see some examples now. Categorizing email messages. Yes, I have email messages. So features extracted from email message, header and content. And what will be the class label here? Spam or non-spam. Then identifying tumor cells. So features extracted from X-rays. See, if I have mail messages with the message header and the content, then I will classify it as spam or non-spam. Then if I have features extracted from X-rays or MRI scans, then I will be classifying it as malignant or benign cells. And features, the third task is cataloging galaxies. Features extracted from telescopic images, so that can be classified into elliptical, spiral or irregular shaped galaxies. So with the input, we have to classify and move the item into a particular classification or a type. Yes, general approach for building a classification model. So if you see this, as I said, this is training set. So this is the training set with which our learning algorithm will learn. So it will take induction, that is, it will take training from the training set, and finally the output of after training is model. Model will be created, then it will be using the test set to predict which it belongs to, the which the classification to which type this input belongs to, which classification this type belongs to. So this is the test set. Okay, so the output will be checked now whether it is correct or not. This is the classification model. So learning algorithm will be there, that will learn with the training set, and the output of training will be model. Then the model will find the will take some test set and it will find the classification, and the output will be tested. So this is the general approach for building the classification model. Next, classification techniques. We have few classifiers in data mining. The classifiers are decision tree based methods. The second one is rule based method, and the third one is nearest neighbor, Naive Bayesian and Bayesian belief networks, support vector machines, neural networks, deep neural networks. These are the base classifiers, and we have another type called ensemble classifiers. The examples of it are boosting, bagging, random forest. So in our syllabus, we have decision tree based methods, rule based method, nearest neighbor and Naive Bayesian classifier. So I'll be posting in the forthcoming videos about these four methods, which will classify the items based on the properties or the features. So with this, I'm winding up my video. Thank you for watching.